Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Deeptesh Patel and I'll be teaching you advanced internal combustion engine. In today's video session, we are going to see the second part of the chapter called heat transfer, friction and lubrication in IC engine. So like in previous session, we have gone through the lubrication system in which we have studied the aim of the lubrication system, the desirable properties of the lubricants and the different types of the lubrication method in IC engine. And especially for this video session, we are going to study the heat transfer and friction in IC engine. So let's start with the heat transfer. Now basically heat transfer is affect the engine overall performance, efficiency and emissions. So since we know that the combustion takes place inside the combustion chamber where the high temperature gases are created and the heat is being transferred from the combustion chamber to the surrounding medium through the cooling water as well. So basically there are three modes of heat transfer takes place: conduction, convection and radiation in IC engine. So let's understand how does this system works and what is the benefits of the heat transfer. Basically the heat transfer reduces the overall power output, because we know that when the heat transfer takes place from the combustion chamber to the surrounding medium, the overall temperature of the gases is reduced and that straight away affect the overall power output of the engine. So the too much amount of the heat transfer is also undesirable, because there would be a reductions of the work output that we are obtaining from the engine. Furthermore, if what happened if the heat transfer does not happen, in that case the temperature of the combustion chamber would reach to the excessive limit, and in that case the various components may get damaged because of the higher temperature. So basically there are three modes of heat transfer takes place in IC engine. Initially, when the combustion chamber inside the combustion chamber, due to the ignitions, the gases are created which is having the higher temperature. So initially the heat transfer takes place because of the two different modes, from the gases to the wall through the convection and through the radiations. So basically there are a force convections takes place from the gases to the inside or inner wall of the combustion chamber, and the radiation because of the emissions and the absorptions of the electromagnetic waves which is emitted by the gases. So convections and radiations from these gases to the inner wall of the combustion chamber. Then from these inner side of the wall to the outer side of the walls, the heat is transferred in the form of the conductions. And then after, from the outside of the wall to the surrounding atmosphere or to the cooling water, the heat is transferred in the form of again convections, which is also a force convection. So this is how the heat transfer takes place from the combustion chamber, inside of the combustion chamber, to the surrounding medium. Now what are the different variables which affect the heat transfer? So these are the few engine variables which have mentioned here that affect the overall heat transfer. And the first one is engine size, right? If we have the larger size of the engine, then in that case the heat transfer would be higher as compared to the lower one with the same amount of the temperature inside the combustion chamber. Second one is engine speed. If the engine speed increase, then in that case the outlet, right, the air and fuel mixture at the outlet, similarly gases at the outlet would also increase, and in that case the heat transfer will also increase. So with increase in engine speed, heat transfer increase. Then load. If the load is increased, then the heat transfer would slightly reduces, because with the similar kind of the load and or with the same amount of the same proportion of the speed required, the larger amount of the air and fuel mixture. So in that case the heat transfer is slightly reduced. Fourth one is inlet air temperature. If the inlet air temperature increase, then in that case the heat transfer rate would also increase. And the last one is swirl and squish. So the swirl is the turbulent which is been created inside the combustion chamber. If the turbulence is increasing, then the heat transfer rate also increase. So these are the five different variables which affect the overall heat transfer from the combustion chamber to the surrounding medium. Now let's move forward to the next one, which is the friction. Now the basic definitions of the friction is the force which is acting between the two rubbing surfaces or the two surfaces which are remain in relative motions. So basically friction is the enemy, cause friction is a kind of losses which occurs in IC engine. Overall power which is developed inside the combustion chamber is known as the indicated power, while the power which is available to the output of the shaft is known as the brake power. And brake power is always less than the indicated power, because certain amount of the power is being consumed, is been lost because of the relative motions in between the pistons and the combustion chamber, in between the rubbing actions, in between the camshaft, crankshaft. So these all losses occurs is because of the friction. So friction can not be completely eliminated, but it can be reduced with the help of few techniques such as the lubrication system. If we apply the good amount of the lubrication system, in that case we can reduce the amount of the friction as well. And there are a few factors which affect the lubrications on the friction, such as the types of the lubricants, or the viscosity of the lubricants, then quantity of the lubricants. So which are the different factor that affects the overall friction. But the friction losses cannot be more than 30%, right? It cannot be more than 30%, otherwise there would be a larger amount of the power that gets lost due to the frictions. Now we are going to see the various sources of losses, right? So in which the friction losses are also considered. So here you can see there are six different sources of losses that occurs in IC engine, and the first one is direct frictional losses. Now this is the remain in a major quantity as compared to the others, because the loss that is occurs inside the combustion inside the IC engine because of the rubbing action between the various components. So like the rubbing action between the piston and cylinder, the rubbing actions or the rolling actions between the camshaft, crankshafts and all other equipments, and that is known as the direct frictional losses. And frictional losses is considered as a major losses in IC engine. Second one is pumping losses, right? The power required for the suction and to push the exhaust gases out is known as the pumping losses, and this is specially considered for the four stroke engine. So the this would be like remain in minor as compared to the direct frictional losses, but that is also consumes a certain amount of the power, right? So the overall power required to get the fresh air and mixture into the cylinder and to remove the exhaust gases from the cylinder. Third one is blow by losses. Now we know that there are a certain amount of the gases they gets leakage past the piston, and they would entered into the crankcase, right? And that is also having certain factors, such as if the pressure is higher, then in that case the leakages will be also high, right? Or the older engine would also have the higher leakages. So blow by losses is nothing but the losses of the gases from the combustion chamber to the crankcase past the piston, right? The space which is being created in between the piston and the inner surface of the combustion chamber or cylinder, right? Fourth one is a valve throttling losses. Now there is a good practice actually that in the exhaust valve is always kept is having always a smaller diameter as compared to the inlet valves, and as the diameter is smaller, so we require the higher amount of pressure to push the exhaust gases out, because the there will be a more resistance because of the smaller diameter. So the power required to remove the exhaust gases after the power stroke or after or during the exhaust stroke is known as the valve throttling losses. Also the power required to suck the air and fuel mixture from the surrounding atmospheres, like air from the atmospheres and fuel from the fuel tank, to the combustion chamber was also considered as a valve throttling losses, because the air fuel mixture has to go through the various components such as the air filter, then carburetor or multi-point fuel injection system or injector. So this is also considered as a valve throttling losses. Then fifth one is a power loss due to drive the auxiliaries. Like we run the a lot of different auxiliaries such as fuel pumps, oil pumps. So that also consumes a certain amount of power as well. And the last one is power to drive the components such as supercharger, turbocharger, right? Supercharger is basically taking the power from the engine. It is definitely coupled with the engines and it takes the power from the engine. Similarly, turbocharger run by the exhaust gases, but however it creates some back pressure issue as well. And in that case, we require the larger amount of pressure to push the gases out of the cylinder. So there are a certain amount of the power loss to drive the different components as well. So these are the different sources of losses that takes place in IC engine. Then mechanical frictions. Basically, mechanical friction has been divided in six different categories. So first one is fluid film or hydrodynamic frictions. This occurs when there is a enough amount of the lubricants that is remaining into the IC engines, and that is also known as the viscous drag. Right? If the viscosity of the fluid is higher, then in that case the friction will also be high as well. Right? Second one is partial film frictions. If we do not have the complete film in between the two different components, in that case the contact of the two components occurs, and due to that the friction will also increase. Or if we consider the crankshaft or maybe connecting rod, the connecting rod will also remain in the contact with the journal bearings, and especially during the low velocity, right, when the engine is starting, when engine is stopping, then in that case the proper amount of the film is not created in between the journal bearings and the connecting and the crankshaft, and in that case the friction occurs, and that is known as the partial film frictions. The third one is rolling frictions. So rolling frictions especially occurs in roller bearings. In that case the roller which is rolling inside the bearing, that would create the certain amount of the pressures, especially when they are completely moving on their own positions. So that is known as the rolling frictions. Then fourth one is a dry frictions. Like in dry frictions occurs when the two different components remain in contact completely and engine runs completely in dry manners, and in that type of the situation occurs when the vehicles was kept like unattended, undrived for the longer period of time. Like if you are driving the vehicles after a month or a couple of months, then in that case there is not proper amount of the lubrications created at initial stage. So when you start the engine at initial conditions, the components come in contact with each other, and because of that the friction occurs, and that is known as the dry frictions. Like however, as soon as you start the engines, the lubrication would also start with the help of the oil pump. So but for the certain time that would remain in dry manners. Then fifth one is a journal bearing frictions, right? The journal bearing frictions, journal bearings friction occurs especially during the zero velocity or the low velocity. So when the engine is starting, when the engine is stopping, then in that case the journal bearings remain in contact. There are not enough amount of the film created in between the journal bearings. So in that case the friction occurs, and that is known as the journal bearing frictions. And the last one is frictions due to piston motions. So like we know that the piston is moving into the cylinder in upward and downward directions. So like because of the motions of the pistons, that is not completely reciprocating, and in that case there is a direct contact between the piston and the cylinder wall, inner wall, and that friction is known as the like frictions due to piston motions. Now that piston is all that friction is also depends on the manufacturers. Like for examples, if we use the too many numbers of ring, then in that case the friction is increased, right? Such as the oil ring and sealing air ring, which seal the combustion mixture into the combustion chamber. Furthermore, if the pressure inside the combustion chamber is also high, then in that case the frictions due to piston motion will also be increased. So these are the six different mechanical frictions, and the mechanical frictions basically divided in six different classes. Now, what are the effect of engine variables on frictions? So we'll go through the different variables here, eight number of variables, and we'll see like what is the effect of these variables on the overall frictions. So first one is stroke to bore ratio. If the stroke to bore ratio increase, then in that case the friction will also increase, because like it is a ratio from length to diameter. So if the length is higher, then friction will be also increase. Second one is cylinder size and the number of cylinder. If we have the higher number of cylinder with the same size of the engine, then in that case the friction will also be high as well. Compression ratio. If the compression ratio is higher, then the friction will also be higher, because the pressure, the indicated mean effective pressure or average pressure inside the combustion chamber is higher, then that would create the lot of adverse effect on the pistons motions, and the friction will also be high. Then the fourth one is engine speed. If we have the higher engine speed, means the higher number of revolutions per minute, and due to that the friction will also increase. Then engine load. If the engine load is high, then in that case the friction would be slightly high as well. Then cooling water temperature. Now cooling water temperature has a direct connections with the lubricating oils. If the cooling water temperature is low, then the lubricating oil would be more viscous. If it is high, then because of the temperature, the lubricant will be less viscous. So cooling water temperature is having also direct connections with the friction as well, right? And it is also advisable that the cooling water temperature should not be too high and too low. Then the seventh one is oil viscosity. Oil viscosity play a very, very important role on the frictions as well. If the oil viscosity is high, then it would create the viscous drags, and that would enhance the friction. If the oil viscosity is too low, then the film cannot be created, proper film cannot be created between the two rubbing surfaces, and in that case the friction will also be high. So selections of the oil and oil viscosity is very, very important for the particular engine. It depends on the overall working pressure of the engines and the applications of the engine. The last one is number of piston rings. Now we use the different types of the rings on the pistons to create the proper sealing of these air and fuel mixture inside the combustion chamber. So if the number of rings is high, then in that case the friction will also be high. So these are the different variables which has a direct effect on the frictions. So this is all at the moment, and this is the end of the chapter, especially for the heat transfer and frictions. If you have any doubt, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you very much.